Dame i gospodo,
ladies and gentlemen, I am the president of New Serbian Democracy, a parliamentary party of part of the people in Montenegro, and a member of the leadership of Democratic Front in Montenegro, and this is the most important item on our agenda today. As you could hear from the discussion so far, Montenegro is a deeply divided society, but one of the most dangerous divisions in Montenegro is based on the disrespect for fundamental rights and freedoms. Montenegro as a state does not wish to recognize those rights to one-third of its own citizens who actually express themselves as Serbs. It will not recognize those rights to the most numerous language community in Montenegro, the one speaking Serbian language, and this is serious discrimination, and it does seriously interfere with the work of the Serbian Orthodox Church in Montenegro. So we have a problem and a division which is most dangerous for the future of Montenegro, and this item on the agenda should deal with that issue as well. But as we can see, we have everything here, rights of LGBT population, minorities, NGOs, animals.
Yet there is no
sentence dedicated to the Serbian national problem and the Serbian language community or linguistic community and the Serbian Orthodox Church as a canonic church that operates in the territory of Montenegro today. So I wish to say a couple of words. Until 1945, traditional national identity in Montenegro was Serbian. Since 1945, we've introduced Montenegrin nation, but there is one-third of the citizens of Montenegro who maintain this traditional Serbian national identity, and many more people opted to speak Serbian language, and that's their right, their choice, and the state must respect and observe that right and that choice. Unfortunately, and there is brutal discrimination by the parties in power and a violent assimilation of the Serbian people and Serbian linguistic community, assimilation implemented in an organized and persistent manner by the parties in power. We have at risk the Serbian language, which should be the language in official use. It's not considered such. Although 60% of the citizens belong to the Serbian Orthodox Church, as the oldest institution in Montenegro, it enjoys the highest level of reputation. Some 10 days ago, the Metropolitan Amphilochia was prevented from serving, from holding a service in Ulcin in a church renewed by Serbian Queen Jelena Anžujska, who was married to one of the Serbian kings from the Nemanjić family. This was obstructed by the state and the local structures, just putting additional pressure on the Serbian Orthodox Church, threatened even to lose its property. As for employment and economic existence, proportionate employment, which should be guaranteed, and it is guaranteed in the constitution and the laws. If you look at the state structure, the army, the police, state administration, judiciary, prosecution, in any of the privileged positions offered by the state, you only have a negligible number of people who claim to be Serbian. So there is a strong pressure for the assimilation process to be completed fully. So dear MPs from the European Parliament, we've been speaking about this for many years. We see that you do not register this problem, you do not note it, and the former Speaker of the Parliament spoke about the Montagnard Constitution. Spoke that the people systematically endangered as the Serbian people in Montenegro have the right to self-defense, and I am simply concerned if we don't have assistance from abroad and your assistance in solving this problem in line with this constitution and in line with the applicable international standards, I think we will have serious issues here in Montenegro.
Mr. Bandić, 1 minute. The differences in Montenegro are very different.
dangerous. You can see how this is manifested here by people who are doing discrimination of Serbian people and have been doing so for many years, and they are caused by our different historic memories. The division lines in Montenegro. This may come as a surprise. This dividing of lines go through families. One brother is a Serb, the other is a Montenegrin. We come closest to each other, but this need for our cousins who rule, who become to this community, who are part of this communist ideology. This is how they talk about people who are not fascists, whose monuments and memorial parks are found in America, how they are spoken of.
Prizivamo pomoć da te naše razlike prevaziđemo. Mi moramo razlike da prevaziđemo.
Apologies, the interpretation booths have done their work. Sorry for this.
Diskriminacije, segregacije, prosto je to nemoguće jer mi ne pristajemo da budemo poniženi.
This is impossible because we do not accept to be humiliated.
Thank you, Mr. Mandić.